How do you know if your child's room has unseen or invisible negative energy? The way we know what it is and where it is by using the most accurate kind of feng shui, classical flying star feng shui. Every building has both positive and negative energies. These energies form in patterns when a building is constructed. Classical feng shui calls the energies that make up the energy patterns flying stars. In every building, there are 9 different energy patterns, one in each of the 8 compass sections and the center. The 9 different energy patterns in a building each have 3 flying stars. The way the 3 flying stars interact with each other creates either a positive or negative energy pattern in that section. These positive and negative energies can have an impact on family members. Some examples of their negative influences are illness, pain, miscarriage, infertility, depression, anxiety, fire, theft, financial problems, arguments, relationship problems, and divorce. Positive influences could be prosperity, good health, fertility, success, fame, and happiness. Ideally, it's best to spend your time where there's positive energy and avoid negative energy, but this might not be possible since there's both positive and negative energy in every home. If a bedroom has a negative energy pattern, the negativity can be reduced or cured by adding the necessary feng shui element. That would be either water, wood, fire, earth, or metal, depending on the energy pattern. There are 144 different energy pattern combinations, and your home has one of those combinations. It's not difficult to find out what kind of positive and negative energies are in your home. You just need the compass degree the home faces and the year of construction. There are several books available that can help you determine what kind of energies you're living in and how to balance them. Creating a Haven, Simple Steps for a Healthy and Nurturing Home is available at barnesandnoble.com and amazon.com. In addition to the energy patterns that formed when your home was built, annual energies move into different compass sections each year, and they also have a positive or negative effect on you. There are 9 different energies. Some are negative, some are positive, and they all shift to their new annual locations each February 4th. We're affected by the energies by spending time in them or using an entry door where they're located. You can find out this year's annual energies at fengshuidiva.com in the Feng Shui Tips and Articles section. Let's do a quick recap of everything we learned in this program. Bedrooms should be yin or quiet for sleeping. Dark bedrooms are healthier because they help your body make melatonin. Positive reminders help kids remember they're loved and can achieve their goals and help keep their thoughts positive. Keeping clutter to a minimum will help keep your child from procrastinating, make it easier to focus on studies, and lessen the chance of depression. Your child has 4 positive sleeping directions and 4 negative directions. It's important to use a compass to point the bed in the right direction. The bed should also be positioned away from energy or chi flow. Make sure there's nothing unhealthy sharing the wall with the bed. Reduce your exposure to EMFs from computers and other electrical things. Every building has unseen or invisible positive and negative energies called flying stars that form in patterns when a building is constructed. There are also annual positive and negative energies that change each February. Negative energies can be cured or reduced by adding the necessary feng shui element, either water, wood, fire, earth, or metal, depending on the energy pattern. Negativity comes in many forms, visible and invisible. Using feng shui can help make your child's room more positive, so you'll have a more balanced home life.